Welcome, senior people in the big room, senior five. This is your teacher, Ogiera Alex. This morning we are going to continue from where we stopped on differentiation using a new concept called rate of change. Rate of change simply applies to a situation whereby a change in one variable affects the other quantity. For instance, if you have a square of size x, a square of size x. Now we know the area of this square A would be x times x, which can be x squared. Now, when this side change, the change in the size of this square as well affects the change in area. That's what we talk of related rate of change. So the rate of change of the size of the square also affects the change in area. So like for example now, if I know the rate of change of the size, as I call the xdt, that is the rate of change of size. And now my area is now A is equal to x squared. I can get the rate of change of area with size. This is the x, which gives me 2x. Now, I will be interested in finding the rate of change of area. Now I know the x dt, if I know it, I also know the a dx. You recall your chain rule? From a chain rule, we can obtain the rate of change of area as the a by the x times the x by the t. Recall your chain rule? And this ideally means if, of course, this is rate of change, I mean the change of area with size, this rate of change of size. So if I combine this, it gives me this rate of change of area. Let's look at this example here. Example here says a spherical balloon is inflated at a rate of 3 cubic centimeter per second. Find the rate of increase of the radius where the radius is 2 centimeters. Now, let us realize that a balloon is spherical. Meaning, if I work out the solution for this number, I know the volume of a balloon, which is spherical. Volume is always in, from a volume of a sphere, is the 4 out of 3 pi r 2, where radius r is the radius of the balloon. Therefore, I can get the v by the r, which gives me now 4 pi r squared from your simple differentiation. Now, what I know in this case is the rate of inflating the balloon, that is the rate of change in volume. So I now know the V by the T, which in this case given as 3 cubic centimeter per second. That is the V, the T. What I'm interested in, I'm looking for the rate of change of radius, which is the VR by the T. Now, I have 3 quantities here. I have the V, the R, have the V, the T, and also the R, the T. Now, how do I relate these 3 quantities now? Still, we need to use our chain rule. Okay? This is our chain rule. So, can I use chain rule now by combining the V by the T to V equals to? Tell me, the V can be the V, the R, times the R by T. This combination of chain rule gives me this quantity. using this variable. Now, do I know divinity? Divinity is given here. So I can substitute my 3 for divinity equals to divinity R, I know divinity parameter, which is here 4 pi R squared. And then, of course, by the R by T, which I'm looking for. So this gives me R by the T to be equals to 3 out of 4 pi R squared from simple making the R T the subject. Now, the question now says, find the length of equations of the radius when the radius is 2 centimeters. Now, this is not the length of change of radius, which is R T. Are you following? Now, in this case now, what I need to do simple. I've been given R to be 2. Therefore, when R is equal to 2, I can now get my R by the T to be 3 out of 4 pi. R is now 2 by square. You simplify this, you get your R T. Fine? Now, we are going to look at more examples in the next video. Thank you so much.